Dear friends, today we are, this session is going to be chapter 6, regulations, insolvency and bankruptcy regulations 2016. I am going to start with committee of creditors. Committee of creditors, as you know, the first step in this process is once the case is admitted, the insolvency professional will be called as interim resolution professional, and he will take over, and his main task is defined, that is, he has to come out with creation of committee of creditors that we have discussed. Now, this particular discussion is going to be on specifically on committee of creditors and the practical issues. Now, regulation 16. Regulation 16 onwards we are starting here. That is, what happens if there are no financial creditor? Operational creditor moves the court and there are no financial creditors. The debt is not there. In what way the resolution professional should go about it? That is the practical issues we are going to discuss. So, what does it say? Regulation 16, if you read, where the corporate debtor has no financial debt, or where all financial creditors are related parties of the corporate debtor, the committee shall be set up in accordance with this regulation. So, there are two situations envisaged in the Act. What is the first one is, there is no financial debt. There is no debt. So, when there is no debt, then how can you constitute a financial creditor? No. Because the situation arises only when either operational creditors moves the court adjudicating authority, or the corporate debtor himself under section 10 comes before the court, NCL adjudicating authority. That is the first step. And so, two situations are envisaged. One is, there is no financial debt. Second is, even though the financial debt is there, all those financial creditors are related parties of the corporate debtor. So, I am the corporate debtor. The definition we have already checked. So, related parties, if that person, a financial creditor, comes under the related parties, then he will not be considered at all. That has been discussed. He cannot participate, he cannot vote, he cannot come to this deliberations, nothing. That is, the law is very clear. So, how to go about it? That is, regulation 16.1 talks about the situation. Here, one important point will be asked. Suppose you have financial debt, but they are not interested to move. That may be also a situation. Suppose what happens to a practical situation where the financial creditor, like a bank or somebody, they are not interested. So, here the question of not interest doesn't arise. So, the proof of claim you must go ahead, failing which, the resolution professional can constitute that based on the books of accounts. That is another. So, three situations are envisaged actually in this regulation. We have to understand. Situation 1, there are no financial debt. Situation 2, financial debt is there, but all are related parties. Situation 3, the financial creditor is there, but is not participating. So, but the situation, first, second only will be discussed in this regulation, because it will be formed if that fellow financial creditor is not a related party, then he has to essentially participate in the meetings. He is the boss. That situation cannot happen, because financial creditor interest will be doomed if he doesn't carry on with these things. So, now regulation 16.2, we are coming to it. So, naturally, there should be a way out, because the operational creditor has moved the adjudicating authority under section 9, and then the case is admitted. Once the case is admitted, interim resolution professional will be appointed. And then what is the duty? Formation of committee of creditors. And there is nobody. Committee of creditors, as you know, will be the only comprises of financial creditors. Now, when there are no financial creditors, then what is the situation? Then comes, the proceedings cannot take place. Now, here, the committee formed under the regulation, I am talking about regulation 2, that is 16.2. The committee formed under this regulation shall consist of members as under 18 largest operational creditors by value. 18 largest creditors. So, here number is very important. The number is important because one fellow may have 75%, then that situation will be a different situation. So, therefore, you want to have a participation. Understand, as you know, in all the controls, there will be one person maker, another is checker. Like this, the Act thought you should have some number and that will be 18. Provided that if the number of operations is less than 18, the committee shall include all such operational creditors. Now, 18 largest operational creditors by value, 1 point. Suppose, for example, there are only 12 operational creditors are there. So, the question of largest doesn't arise. All that 12 will be included. Even if it is very small, that is the point. So, in the act, what happens is you take too many people with a crowd. But if you have only few people, then they will take a dominating thing. So, therefore, to balance that operational creditors, this particular provision has been introduced. Then, second one is, one representative elected by all workmen, other than those workmen included in A above. So, a workman can always be an operational creditor also, can supply goods to the company, there is an agreement. And so, he may also be a working in that company. So, in that case, only those workmen who are not part of the operational creditor will come into this picture. Right. You want to have larger participation. That is the intention of the legislature. C, 2C. Section Regulation 16, subsection 2, subsection C. One representative elected by all the employees. One representative elected by employees are different from workmen. So, therefore, the workmen as defined under the various labor laws are there. Workmen's Compensation Act, Industrial Dispute Act, things like that. But employee is an official. So, there is a distinction between the workman and employee in this. One representative elected by all the employees other than those employees included in the A above. So, you want to have a new person. Same person cannot have double action. So, you take a situation like Kingfisher. Of course, Kingfisher, everything is only loan. But the situation is like that. There are employees are there, workman is there, and then financial creditors, operational creditors, all are there. Financial creditors, discussion is over. Now we are getting in a situation when there is no financial creditor. How should we go about this? This situation is different. Now let's go to regulation 3. A member of the committee formed under this regulation shall have voting rights in proportion of the debt due to such creditor or a debt represented by such representative as the case may be. To the total debt. So now, regulation 1 and 2 envisages a list. Suppose I have operational creditors, you take full operational creditors, and suppose if they are more than 18, then you are going to take 18%, and then that is you come from the top to down, the total debt will be taken to that extent of 18 people. Suppose, if you read this law, the law says 18 largest operational creditors by value. Suppose, for example, operational creditors are 100 lakhs and there are about 50 operational creditors are there. First 18 only 80 lakhs. And then only that 80 lakhs shall be included in the computation of the debt. That is the first point. Now, this is going to be a troublesome situation. The Act has not envisaged. For example, of course, it's the largest value they have talked about it. So, obviously, the chance of a person not having much claim and then trying to get it will not arise. So, that is a well thought of a policy. So, the object of having too many people crowding, that is eliminated, and at the same time representative operational creditors. So, that is the first step. So, for example, now 18 largest value is, let us say, 80 lakhs, even though there is a total of 100 lakhs. So, total operational creditors are 100 lakhs, 15 number. But the largest, first 18 largest in the descending order, if you take, it comes to 80 lakhs. Then you have to take only 80 lakhs. That is the rule number one. Now, let's go to the next level. Regulation 16.3 we are talking about. Here what happens, one representative elected by all workmen other than those workmen included in clause A above. So, here they would like to take that particular who is going to represent the workman's interest. So, here obviously at 24 months preceding they become priority. So, therefore all the workmen who are there, total amount preceding 24 months that will be taken, let us say 30 lakhs, that is the total. That will be represented by one person and these people must select them, that's all. Third, you can see proof of claim also, when you discuss that proof of claim, how the proof of claim has to be worked out, we discussed in the previous video. So, that you will get a picture, but now 24 months 30 lakhs, then this is workman, only pure workman, he should not be a double action. And then employees also, you will have 12 months preceding that whatever is the due amount due to the these fellows, only to the extent of 12 month dues. Other dues will go to unsecured creditor because they will come under section 53 second part A, B, B little come. So, 12 months means, let us say, it comes to 110, let us say 40 lakhs, totally 150 lakhs. Now, this is the committee of creditors, and in proportion to this will be handled. If you see the regulation in detail once again, the situation is clear. The law is very clear. Only we need to have financial creditors running the show. But there can be a situation where the financial creditor is out while is the financial debt is not there, or even if it is there, all of them are related parties. That two situations only this regulation will come into picture. And second, what is that there nobody to committee, then they gave a beautiful picture wherein regulation 16.2 ABC will be discussed, and that is what I have done. And finally, you are going to have the committee is already formed, and then the decision making also, neither to give representation to all the interests, but at the same time don't overcrowd them and make it very feasible, not like a labor union strike and people start fighting each other. That is the issue. Up to regulation 3 we completed.